Hey guys, welcome to the Hour of Devastation Commander Deck Builder Challenge videos. If you're watching the gameplay, there are four other Deck Builder Challenge deck techs all around. Check the links. And then if you're watching a deck tech, check the link. And then three other links for those deck techs and the gameplay.
We're learning how to do links.
Yes, we're trying to push the limit. So
look, a link.
check them out. Hopefully you like it.
Hey guys, this is Eric here at CollectorMania, doing my Neheb the Eternal deck tech for the Hour of Devastation Commander Deck Builder Challenge. Building Neheb here, it's really good. I think he's a 4-6, or maybe she for 5, is that right?
I believe it's a he, and yeah, it's a 4-6.
Okay, and when, in your post-combat main phase, you get a red mana for every damage dealt to an opponent each turn. So pretty good. The whole theme of this deck here is kind of like a world burn. That's why we've got the world fire image in the background here. There's a lot of instants and sorceries that deal damage, or even creature abilities and stuff that deal damage to all players, all creatures, that sort of thing. It might be a little kind of like Suicide Red slash, you know, it's a little knife's edge. We have some mitigation for that, but we'll see. The first thing we're going to do is get into our creatures here. And I've just highlighted a few. Some of my favorite cards and ones that kind of fit this theme is Coal Hauler Swine. I've always wanted this card to work. It's really bad. But whenever he takes damage, it deals damage to all other players. So that may not work too well. There's some ways around that in the deck that you'll see here. But one of my favorites is kind of a goofy one. Great art, too. Next, we've got Godo Bandit Warlord. Another great tutor card if you need, like, a piece of equipment brought into play, especially in red, which kind of doesn't have that. It's definitely more of a white thing. He can bring one into play for you. You'll see in my artifact section, I'm looking for ways to protect my commander or take damage off of me while still hitting the rest of the board. So you'll see that. Godo's a great one for mono-red equipment search. Next, we have Gutter Snipe from Return to Ravnica. Really good creature here. Whenever you play an instant or sorcery, you deal 2 damage to all opponents. So pretty no-brainer here. I think there's a total of 28 instants and sorceries in the deck. Kind of a spell-heavy deck, so the fact that you can deal damage every time you play something is great, especially since if we do that in our first main phase, or if we're lucky an instant in like combat or something, or even just combat damage, getting a ton of mana in the post-combat main phase. And then the last creature here is a War Elemental. Again, not the best one. Another one I tried similar to Coal Hauler Swine. This one says, when he comes into play, an opponent has to have taken damage, otherwise you sacrifice him. And every time a player takes damage as well, he gets bigger and bigger. It may just be opponent, I'm not sure. But I think when I'm dealing, like, say, 4 to all opponents, and there's hopefully going to be 3 opponents in the game, it's 12 counters that goes on him. So he can get really out of hand really quick. Definitely a cool card. There's a whole bunch of other ones, some typical, like, some other activated abilities that deal damage, some great ramp, some defensive stuff in here. I took a look at Kiley's deck and Steve's deck, of course, doing the production here, and I don't know. Some flyers might get through, but we'll see. Moving on, we're going to go to our artifact section here. Red and artifacts just go hand in hand, and I love it. Just to go through things, there's a little bit of a protection package, as I mentioned, and there a few of them are equipments. The first one here is Dark Steel Plate. Just the idea, equipped to Neheb, if I'm dealing damage to, let's say, like an Earthquake ability where it deals X to players and creatures without flying, I want my commander to survive more than just 6 damage. So giving him Indestructible keeps him safe from that. A second version, it's not as good. I think it's really cool. I think it's from M10. Back when I used to play, I remember pulling these in packs and stuff. Was the Mage Bane armor. I think it's +2/+4, loses flying, but it survives all non-combat damage, so you prevent all non-combat damage to a creature. Again, really good if you're burning everything with like an Earthquake ability just to keep your commander alive. Something to keep me alive is the Pariah Shield. This one is damage dealt to me is instead dealt to equipped creature. So this would be good in combination with the Dark Steel Plate or the Mage Bane armor, or something like Coal Hauler Swine or Stuffy Doll, just if those are equipped. I think it would be an infinite combo if I got one of those two creatures, the equipment, either the equipments to keep them alive, and then, or no, that wouldn't work because it prevents non-combat. So just the Dark Steel Plate, that's the only way that would work. But yeah, you can burn people out with like essentially 3 cards there. Next, we have Pyromancer's Goggles. Again, we're dealing with a lot of instants and sorceries. For 5 to play, I think, if you add a red to your mana pool, spend it on an instant or sorcery, you get a copy. So if you're dealing, like Fiery Confluence, let's say, has 3 modes, you can choose the same mode multiple times. You can deal 2 damage to each opponent 3 times, so 6, and double it. So, excuse me. Yeah, 6 times 3, so 18, 36, right? If my math's wrong, check me. Then you get all that mana in post-combat main phase to do some gross stuff. So hopefully copying some crazy spells there, we'll see. As I mentioned, there's a lot of burn to everyone, including myself. So there's a little bit of pull-up emergency maneuvers here. We've got the Staff of the Fire Magus and also the Dragon's Claw. Just kind of like some incremental life gain. Staff only works for me when I play a red spell or play a mountain. But the Dragon's Claw works for everybody playing red, and what, 3 out of us are playing red?
Yeah.
So hopefully that'll gain me a little bit of life. There's Iron Star as well, which is first part of this, but you got to pay for it, so not so great. And then moving on, our last artifact is the Tower of Fortunes. It's really 4 to play, 8 to activate, which is kind of pricey, but draw 4 cards, which is really good, especially if you've got, like I said in that previous example, 36 mana post-combat. So, drawing 4, pretty good. There's some other really good draw spells in here, just trying to, fuel the turn. After artifacts, we just have one really quick enchantment, which is Pyrohemia. It says if there's no creatures in play, destroy the enchantment, but for a single red, you can deal 1 damage to all creatures and players. You can do that any number of times, so that one's really good. After that, we've got our instance groups, and just a few there. Again, these are somewhat similar. Some of them just, these are the tricky ones, I guess. The first one we have is Arc Bond. It's an instant. I think it costs 3 whenever you can target a creature. Whenever that one deals damage or takes damage this turn, it deals that damage to all other players as well. So that'd be really good if somebody's chumping against something huge or my creature's about to die, and then all of a sudden I get the damage through anyway, and then there's Neheb giving me a whole bunch of post-combat mana. And then next, a really good dig spell is Commune with Lava. What you do here is you exile a bunch of X cards, and until the end of your next turn, not the current turn, you can play those cards. So that's a really great way to just dump a whole bunch of mana, looking at some really inexpensive spells, some with some ways to cheat them into play, and then I have a number, essentially this half a turn and the whole next turn of mine to play those. So a really great one there. Moving on to sorceries. Just a few again. There's a lot more sorceries. They're kind of heavy hitters as far as dealing all damage to a lot of players and ground creatures. One of the best one and a really great cycle too is the Confluence cycles from C15. I've got Fiery Confluence there, and really I'm looking at, I guess it's the second mode. Deal 2 damage to all players again for 4 mana. If I just copy that once, I'm getting 18. So if there's 3 people in play. Of course, all these spells get a little worse if there's only, say, 1 opponent. But there's some finishers for them as well. Speaking of finishers, we have Ignite Memories here, a Storm card. Reveal a card from their hand at random and take damage equal to CMC. If you can Storm that and hit a bunch of people a bunch of times, really great card. We're super lucky to have one, too, because I know Seth was looking forever to try to track one down. Next, we've got Incite Rebellion, I think from Commander, or Conspiracy 2.
No, it's Commander
16, maybe?
It's one of those guys.
Yeah, one of the new ones. It's definitely neat. But it says a player takes damage equal to their number of creatures they control. So I'm looking at Greg and Kiley here with their token decks, and hopefully going to blow them out with that. We'll see. And then the last sorcery we have here is just Reforged Soul. If I have a ton of mana, I'm probably not going to have much of a hand. Also, in our artifact section, we had some good draw. The crack ones Mind's Eye and Hedron Matrix and stuff, and then Mind's Eye to hopefully help us draw. But Reforge the Soul, and I am super lucky because I think you've got it in your deck, right, Steve? And I think Kylie also has it too. So there's kind of 3 chances to replenish our hands in these decks. It's going to be nuts. But yeah, that's kind of the sorcery group there. Lastly, we've just got some land. Pretty standard. I am not a huge fan of non-basics, and I actually have a Price of Progress in here, which deals 2 damage to each opponent for each of their non-basics. So I'm trying not to run a whole bunch of them. So a lot of mountains in the deck, I think a total of 29. The 2 non-basics I do want to highlight here is Hall of the Bandit Lord. really great. You can pay 3 life, you get a colorless mana, and if you spend that on a, I think, just a red creature, it gets haste. One from Champions of Kamigawa. Really good, especially if I'm looking to swing with my creatures, or maybe activate an ability of one, that sort of thing. And then last, Valakut. Really great one from the Zendikar block. And the idea here is, during your first main phase, if you play a land and you have enough mountains in play, Valakut triggers and deals 3 damage to somebody. If Neheb's in play, of course, in my post-combat main phase, that's 3 free mana. So definitely a good one in kind of the red burn type like build. So that's pretty much the deck. Hopefully you enjoy it. If you get a chance, check out the other deck techs and gameplay videos as well. All the deck lists and stuff are posted in each description of each video as well. And as normal on YouTube, if you like some content, show us, tell us what we're doing right or wrong. If you have some suggestions or something you're crying out to see, please let us know. And then, of course, if you could like, subscribe if you think we're worthy of it. So hopefully see you guys here in the shop for the Hour of Devastation release here in just a few days on Friday, the 14th?
Yeah.
Yeah. And then if not, online. So thank you.